respect to the point X. Okay, so this is the harmonic measure. So for instance, if you have like, if you imagine Brownian motion starting from this point, the harmonic measure will say, so give the probability of sort of hitting a certain part of the boundary. So that's the harmonic measure. And so here is it's like a set integral. But this is sort of well defined, and you can sort of think about it. It's just an integral sort of version of Minkowski addition. And one can think about it position. It says that, so if omega, if the base domain, if that lies in C, then a family of convex sets parametrized by Z in omega, this is subharmonic. If and only if we take the sort of the total set here, and if we sort of add, we take the product with, if A times sort of the imaginary parts here to the power n. So this now would be this would be a subset in Cn times C, right?
But A is what?
Yeah, so A is the union of A set. So here you have like A set. So A set is in Rn, but then I add sort of this this imaginary part. Okay, so now this is a subset in Cn, but which is sort of independent of the imaginary part. Okay. Okay, and now the proposition says that, well, the family A set is subharmonic in that sense if and only if this subset is pseudo-convex.
Assume and think about AZ, like it's a convex.
Yeah. Everything is.
A is convex.
Family of convex. This is all. They are all convex.
They are all convex.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I don't. I
and in Rn. Okay. In Rn still. Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So in particular, if you have a pseudo-convex set like this, which is independent of the imaginary part, if you look at the entry of the volume of these sort of real parts, that's going to be super-harmonic. Okay? And this is like a strengthening of one of Bo's results, because Bo proved the same thing, but with the logarithm of that this is super harmonic. Yeah, but now we get that this is super harmonic.
So you have this stronger boundary.
No, it's not. Yeah. I mean, this has nothing. I mean, this has nothing to do with the boundary. This is like a local. Yeah, but convexity of the A set, but you get that automatically if you have if it's pseudo convex
and invariant. Yes. Uh-huh. But so there is the relation of Bo's result that he has a general thing about Berger, but then he gets symmetry, you end up with these volumes. That's
no, the thing is, well, okay, no, the connection with Bo's result is that Bo goes via two subharmonic functions.
Yeah.
And Prekopa.
And
Prekopa. Yeah, he proves this Prekopa version for.
Right, because that's the general thing about the Bergman kernels.
No, but
it's earlier.
Yeah, you can also get it.
Yes, using the symmetry first.
Yeah, but okay, so but the main difference is that Bo uses Prekopa. And I guess the main theme there was on pluripotent harmonic functions, and I guess Julius will talk more about convex functions. here is so the proof here is not difficult, but it's, there is one, I think, interesting thing when proving that a pseudo-convex set like this is subharmonic. So this relies on Kieselmann's minimum. That's how you see that. So Bo's result gave a new proof of Kieselmann's minimum principle. So you need to input something like that. But you can also prove Kieselmann's minimum principle by sort of some direct calculation. So that is a nice little calculation actually. But so let me just say, so this uses. So it's not trivial. It needs some machinery to do it. Okay.
So if you formulate things in terms of the support functions of the complex sets,
yes.
You're not saying that these functions, well, it's complex. You want
yeah.
complex entire variables and say that it's PSH can only be this.
Yeah, but then, yeah, so you do that. So you go to the support functions, and then the point is you want to say that the support functions of a set is. You want to say that the support function of a set is super harmonic in set. That's what you need to show. And that